Hello, everyone. Today I looked at this little aluminum Coke bottle and thought, why not turn it into a signal booster for a DIY antenna? The first step is simple. Drill a small hole right at the center of the cap, just tight enough for a valve stem to screw in securely. Once it fits snugly, the foundation is set. Once the hole is done, simply secure the valve stem into the cap. No need to question anything yet, just follow the steps, and the further we go, the clearer the whole picture will become. With the valve secured, we move on to the next step. Drill a small hole on the aluminum bottle body. This hole will hold a bolt and nut set, making it easy to attach an extra wire later without any hassle. After drilling, I take a knife and scissors to trim off a section of the bottle near the bottom. This opening will allow the bottle to act as an extension piece, helping the antenna capture signal more effectively. To make the most of it, I use scissors to trim the bottle's body into several thin fins. Once spread out, these fins act like small signal catchers, improving the antenna's reach. In my hand now are a bolt, two washers, and three nuts. I might have grabbed one extra, but never mind. Once secured onto the bottle, these will make it easy to attach an electrical wire without any fuss. Here I have two simple wires. Connecting them is straightforward. You can see how it works at a glance. If you're new to DIY and have little experience with electricity, just follow along carefully, and I'll guide you step by step. This is a telescopic antenna, extendable and retractable. We proceed as usual. One wire connects to the antenna, the other to the bottle. Together, they create a supportive structure that captures signals more effectively. For electrical safety, wrap part of the wires in their connections with insulating tape. This keeps things tidy and prevents any risk of short circuits. To make the extendable antenna stay firmly in place, we use hot glue. It's simple and keeps everything secure for the long run. Of course, we can't skip making the antenna base. Feel free to get creative. But if you're stuck for ideas, you can follow my approach. This is a recessed electrical plug. We'll connect the remaining ends of the two wires to this plug, preparing for a safe connection to the power source. This antenna assembly is now complete, though it still needs a connecting wire. So I'll go prepare the wire right away. First, get a male electrical plug ready. We'll connect one end of the coaxial cable to it. I've done this many times before, so I'm pretty comfortable with it. The other end of the coaxial cable will be connected to a straight F connector and a 90 degree F connector. These connectors are meant to link directly to the TV. All right, everything is set. I can't wait to test it. So let's connect the antenna assembly to the TV right now. In less than 3 seconds after connecting, the screen lit up, but we won't jump to conclusions just yet. Let's wait a little longer to see how it holds up. We waited a moment and saw nothing unusual, so I decided to unplug the wire and plug it back in to see the response. After that test, I can confidently say it's a success. This DIY antenna works really well with strong and stable signal, even beyond what I expected. The assembly process isn't complicated either. Just follow the steps carefully and have a bit of patience. If you want to try it at home, start with the basics, enjoy the creative process, and most importantly, always prioritize electrical safety. Once it's all set up, there's a real joy in seeing something you built with your own hands working perfectly.